If you want to get into the trailer industry, the best video editing software to learn is either Premiere Pro or Avid Media Composer. Keep watching to find out why and what I use.
It's Premiere Pro.
Hi, my name is Derek Liu. I've made indie game trailers for over 7 years now, but I've worked on trailers of all sorts for over 17 years, both in the movie and game trailer industry. And I always get asked about editing software, so I thought I'd tell you what I use.
I use Premiere.
Why I use it, and what I've used in the past. Like I said, if you want to get into the trailer industry, you're going to have to learn Premiere Pro, Avid Media Composer, or both, because job security. The reason is simply because those are currently the most commonly used software in movie and game trailer houses, and you'll be able to get up and running much faster if you don't have to learn a new software package for the job. That said, I know movie trailer editors and producers who started as assistants without knowing any editing software whatsoever. They simply learned on the job. The caveat is, if you want to take that approach, you're going to have to start at the very bottom as an intern or a runner, because no one is going to hire and pay you for your on-the-job training if you're not already doing some sort of work. That said, just because you're an expert on Premiere or Avid doesn't mean they're going to immediately give you TV spots or trailers to cut if you don't have any work experience. So why do trailer houses use Premiere and Avid Media Composer? Let's start with Avid. The film industry has used Avid for many decades now, simply because for a long time it was really the only editing software anyone could use. And if it ain't broke, don't fix it. The trailer houses that use Premiere most likely do so because they used Final Cut Pro up through version 7, and Premiere was the easiest to transition to at the time. At the professional level, changing the software everyone at a company uses is very, very risky because of cost, mostly due to lost productivity as everyone gets back up to speed. Many professional editors have used the same software for over a decade or more, and they're as fast on it as a concert pianist or professional StarCraft player. Changing video editing software is like being given a keyboard in a different language with a different layout.
Second thoughts, you type.
Some things will look familiar, but there will be just enough differences to give you pause for just about every task you perform. Trailer houses are a business, so any delays can mean lost money or even clients. Even if there's some hot new editing software on the market, they will need a very compelling reason to change their entire company over to the new software. Also, being on the same software means it's easier to share project files, bin files, and things like that. It's more likely they'll set up one station with a new editing software package for minor work before going all in. Going into the design benefits of Premiere and Avid is enough for another video entirely, so leave a comment below if you'd like me to make a video about the differences between the two. I currently use Premiere Pro and have used it since CS 5.5 because I was one of those editors who weren't satisfied with Final Cut Pro 10's features, and Premiere Pro was the closest thing to Final Cut Pro 7 at the time, so I jumped ship. My first editing software was actually Premiere, but it was version 5.1, and this was 20 years ago. That's before Creative Cloud and Creative Suite were a thing. Once Final Cut Pro came out, I stuck with that until Final Cut Pro 10's release and moved on to Premiere. The biggest reason I started using Premiere is because it can edit H.264 MP4 files, whereas Final Cut Pro 7 required you to transcode MP4 files into a more edit-friendly video codec like ProRes. At this point, I just use Premiere because I'm super familiar with it, I like its editing shortcuts, and also I haven't spent much time to look at alternatives. I do keep aware of other editing software currently being developed. I checked back in with Final Cut Pro 10 when they release major updates, but it's currently still missing some deal-breaker editing features like replace edit at match frame. Plus a few other fundamental editing tools I just can't be without. I also keep an eye on DaVinci Resolve because they've been slowly building up the editing functions, and because it's a one-time payment instead of subscription-based software. And also there's a free version. I mostly look at the new shiny software because I'm attracted to the idea of editing software built from the ground up for modern systems. Premiere feels like the Homer Simpson car with everything under the sun crammed together into one monstrosity. I think this is because in the Final Cut Pro days, Premiere was off doing their own thing, and then when people left Final Cut Pro, they started adding stuff on, all while trying to not alienate their existing customers. I mean, just look at how huge and overwhelming this right-click menu is. Now look at the right-click menu for DaVinci Resolve. That pretty much sums up the difference between something new built from the ground up and something old which suddenly got a lot of new features added. But for now, I'm sticking with Premiere because that's what works for me. My dream editing software is just something which has the core features I need and feels smooth and responsive to edit with. Granted, if I didn't edit as much with H.264 files, that would fix a lot of my problems, but whenever I've used either the old Final Cut Pro 7 or DaVinci Resolve, it's like I'm playing a game at 60 frames per second instead of 15 frames per second, and it makes me dream of a better editing future. How to pick the editing software best suited to your needs is also enough for another video entirely, so if you'd like me to make a video for that, or the Premiere Avid comparison, please let me know in the comments. If you want weekly trailer making tips, please sign up to my newsletter at gametrailertips.com. And as a bonus, you'll get my free game trailer editing checklist. As always, thanks to my top Patreon supporters who help me make more videos like this.